What's up, everyone? This is Tyler Silver, and today I want to show you guys my silver pickups I picked up while I was in Sydney. So, here is the first one right here. It's a small little bag. It's from Jaggards. Full focus. One cool thing is they're the official agents for the Sydney 2000 Olympic coins. So, they have the special rights to sell just the 2000 Olympic coins. And that's amazing and accomplished for a small silver shop that's just in Sydney. It's quite small if you go in it. It has like four display cases, but with the four display cases, they do have a lot of things. And Moose is walking in the background if you can hear him. Hold up. There's Moose. I haven't had him in a video in a while, so decided I'll just add him in this video. Moose. Or he sees something. Definitely sees something through the fence, but we're just gonna go back on our video and leave Moose alone to whatever he does out here. But this is what it came in. It's a white little box. It's tells you the coin. It's Feast of the Dream, the serial code, another serial code, and it's like another like COA right there, a box. But here is the coin itself in this package. It's a United States flag privy mark coin. So if we open it up, here is the COA for it. There is the coin. If we look at the COA, it's from the Perth Mint. The has some just information about the United States and the flag and stuff like that. The max number is 18,500 of these coins were released by the Perth Mint. This coin number is 1,140, so we didn't get below 1,000, but still below 5,000. And here is the coin itself. If we bring it up, there it is. I had to pick this up. It looked gorgeous in the shop and still looks gorgeous. And I was in Australia, I live in the United States, so it just made sense. They have the United States flag privy. So I decided just to pick it up because I love kookaburras, the Perth Mint, Australia, and the United States. So it's a lot of things I love all in one. And the backside is just this normal backside of kooks and stuff. It's $1. It's 1 ounce of silver. Don't know the exact price of this. I was on eBay. I only found one listing for this exact coin. It was $145 for the listing, and I paid nowhere near that much. I paid a lot lower, so I'm glad about that. I don't know if that's accurate price of these coins. I don't think so. It's just a little upcharged since it's the only coin on eBay. So if you guys do know the price of this, I'd love to know. But that's the first pickup I got, so let's put the COA back so I don't lose it. So if I do lose it, well then, it makes no sense. So well, let's look at the next one. Okay, so here's the next one. It's in the same white thing. It's a little dirty, but I'm gonna keep it. There's like that one thing that won't get off, but I'm gonna keep it because it's nice. It protects the box that it is in. It does say what it is, so if we do put it up close, if it focuses, there we go. It actually tells you another serial code number for the box itself. And you can see the Sydney 2000 Olympic logo right there, and it tells you right here what it is. So basically, you already know what it is. So I'm just gonna pull it out, and we will look at it in more detail. Oh, here's this thing. I was looking for this thing for the video. This is the store, Jaggards. There's like no lighting, so it won't work. It's a Sydney Gold Shop. It's late at night, so I'm surprised the lighting even. Is this good? It's not bad. It's not as I wanted, but it'll do for this video since I do want to put up a video. Since I haven't put up a video in a week since I was on vacation, but here it is. It's the Sydney 2000 Olympics right there, the logo, and it's a coin collection, the cultural series. So they do have. This is 8 coins in the whole Sydney Olympic coin series. There's 16 coins. That one was around like $800, and I didn't have $800, so I went for this one, which was less expensive than $800, but still pretty expensive. I picked it up because it was 2000, the year I was born in, and it was the Olympic coin, so I really wanted Olympic coins. And also, Sydney, I was in Sydney, and I just decided to pick it up since it was my birth year and I was in Sydney and I found this, so it was just perfect timing. So if we open it up, there should be a COA. Yeah, here is the COA. Pull that out. Here's the COA. It's number 429. I think there's only a max number of 5,000. Yeah, the maximum number of sets is 5,000, but per design. So each one of these designs have 100,000 minted towards them. And they're all 1 ounce of silver, 0.99. And here are the names of the coins. It's Festival of the Dreaming, a Sea Change 1, a Sea Change 2, Reaching the World 1, Reaching the World 2, Harbor of Life Water, Harbor of Life Land, and Harbor of Life Air. So, they're like generic names for them. I don't think it was, they put a lot of time in making the names since it just basically tells you what the design is and pretty generic. So if we just look at the first one, we're gonna go this way. This one is stuck in the actual thing, so I can't get it out. I will have to take out all the coins and then pop it out from the back, because this slot right here is made smaller than the coin, so you actually have to shove the coin in there, which is okay, but I really don't want it me to keep on moving this in and out. Maybe it'll ruin the capsule, but for the video I will do it. So we're gonna look at this first one. Here it is. It is a Sydney Bridge, and all the designs are different and they all have a lot of detail. So the first thing you can see on every coin, which is similar, is the Sydney 2000 Olympic logo on the bottom of it. And then everything else is different about the coins besides the back. And there should be text on the side. I don't think you'll be able to see it, but I can barely see it. It says like game. It says the Olympics and stuff like that. Maybe I'll have a picture of that. All the backs are the same, $5. And it has the year 2000 on the back. But if we look at the front of it, they all have different designs. I'm going to try to rush through this since I just noticed it was 8 minutes for this video. So I'm going to show you guys these designs really fast. If you want to keep on looking at them, you can pause the video. But every border is different. This one has water, sailboats, and boats. And it is the Sydney Bridge. So if we move on to the Opera House right here. The Opera House, it's the Sydney Opera House. Another iconic thing that you have to see while you're in Sydney. You don't have to see, but truly world known, the Opera House. I actually went in it. I took some pictures. There's actually purple carpet inside, which is really weird on this one floor. It's just all purple carpet. I did take a picture of it. I'll probably have it on screen right now. It's really weird in design, and it's just concrete inside. But this one is the Opera House with a boat, and then you can see the border is different. It's actually the city line, just around in a circle. So with the next one, I'm gonna skip this one because I can't get out. This one is just Australia. Australia with sailboats, bigger sailboats on the outside. It's pretty, you can just look at it and see what the design is. And then this one, I don't know the names of the coins, the exact coins. They did give me 8 names. I'm gonna have to figure out which one's which. You can probably guess, but I don't want to guess wrong, since in most of my videos I do make a lot of mistakes. But this one is another hard one to get out. There we go. I think there's like a, what's it called, a radar thing, a city, and I think that's another city right there. Oh no, it's a nuclear plant. Nuclear plant, a city, and the communication right there, and these are the globes. So this must be like the communication around the world, or a reach around the world, or whatever it was called in here. If we look at it, here's the COA. Reaching the world 1 or 2. So it's either one of those, since it is reaching the world, I assume. And then this one is just some birds and the ocean. And the border is different. It's just clouds and wind right now. I don't know if there's a kookaburra in here. I really can't tell. But I do love this design. It has a lot of different birds and bird species that are in Australia, and shows all of the different ones. And then this one is my least favorite out of the 8, but still a nice design. It goes from like the earliest boats to the modern boats, to the earliest planes to the modern planes up there. On both sides, it's the exact same thing. And then this is just different kinds of people. So this must be the other reaching the world, since there's a lot of different kind of people in that coin, and it shows that Sydney is diverse and stuff like that. And we focus. There we go. It focused. That is all I picked up. Thank you guys for watching. I will have my Sydney video up in a couple days. It takes a long time to edit, since there's a lot of footage. I don't want to make it like an hour long, since all the footage is like an hour and a half long. But I'll probably cut it down to like 5 to 10 minutes. So it'll be bearable. So if you want to watch that, it'll be out on my channel next couple of days. Thank you guys for watching. Keep on stacking, and see you later.